is a follow-up theory to Sacred Salvation, the second video of the Trinity Formation, now shedding light on Zelda's doom brought upon by her blood relation. As explained prior, the realm of the Kami has been accessible. Link has to request help from the Kami in his quest of all, and therefore, would have the highest of the Kami answer his call. Her Holiness herself, Hylia Spirit, provides help from beyond the stage, stopping evil from spreading in the terrifying rampage. But who exactly is Hylia in this day and age? Since ancient times in the land of Japan, the religion of Jindo reigns, later turned into Shinto after having Buddhism and Taoism ingrained. Though their influence, the core Kami have always remained, as the nation's proud flag symbolics will show to still contain, the glowing red rising sun with the beams of light breaking through. To the Zelda franchise, this isn't anything new. For everything holy, only the power of light holds true. For the deeper meanings must be viewed. Long ago, in Japan's distant past, many wars had amassed and were surpassed. But with a guiding light, the sun hitting from behind, some were greeted with many victories in their fights. The goddess of the sun wanted earth to be one, as the earth and heavens were once one. With the ruler of the heavens at their backs, to have come out at the top, reuniting the country for the wars to stop. The earthly realm following Amaterasu's plea did not subject, so she sent her grandson to Japan carrying three regal objects, the sacred treasures, the outer sword, the jewels, and the mirror, now bestowed to the people, as all of these were presents once bestowed upon her. He dispersed the barrier, creating a cloud path, went alone, tinned udder, carrying the heavenly sword of gathering clouds, later known as the grass cutter. The imperial line, carrying the bloodline from Amaterasu, dedicated to Jinja, the Isa Grand Shrine, claiming their rule to be true due to their victories, believing to stay in touch with her guidance for all this time. As explained in a previous video, a Jinja is a place where Kami are being worshipped, prayers and offers being granted. But in this specific Jinja, there are far more demands that need to be met. The females of the imperial bloodline carry out duties as priestesses, for their connections to Amaterasu are far greater, allowing them to channel her through their bloodline, seeing revelating dreams and acting as a divine mediator. For this story bearing many familiarities to be considered, the Legend of Zelda's aspects are a bit different. Waging war against Demon King Demise, in battle badly injured, she sealed him and had enacted a sacrifice. Counting on the strength of the mortals to intertwine, she became one of them and started the Imperial Line to continue to let her light shine. Though losing her immortality by stripping herself of her divinity, this was done with absolute clarity of the threat into infinity. An act carried out on behalf of the futures to come to Hyrule, as the name indicates, was formed into Goddess Hylia's rule and her future gene pool. To guard the land's peace, leaving behind her Sword of Evil's bane, she had to go back to the heavens from which she came. No longer visible to be able to immediately interact with the plane. To be forced as a spectator for most of the game. As she believed the true intention to why the Triforce was made was for mortals to decide their own fate. To provide hope when quality of life has decayed. She can still be found whenever people pray. Hearing their pleas, she acts to retain the world of the mundane. Though her Kami essence can be seen to wane, as the spiritual realm seems to overlap at dusk when light fades, and the Demon King has figured it out to be the right time to escape. Thus the imperial line, those descendant carrying the blood of the goddess. Whenever evil strikes back, it comes down to them to put a stop to the mess. Though with the aid of the chosen hero, it is Princess Zelda who has to enact in her stead. In Breath of the Wild proved to be quite a task, as her connection appeared severed. Unaware of where her power stems from, and thus unable to connect with her, she deeply resents herself for her own failures, for not being able to call upon the power transfer, as her predecessors managed to do so, to look deeply from within, to summon forth the sacred power of light that only resides with her kin. It must be fueled by love and gratitude for the intentions that are well, in order to protect the peace and prosperity within Hyrule, to avoid turning the heavens into hell. But Hylia didn't count on just the Imperial family to enact a counter-strike, as many other measures were put into motion to channel powers of which are godlike. First, the Master Sword, which was once her own goddess sword, the handle made from Imperial Jade, the most spiritual material on record, infused with the holy flames by its master, forged into the ultimate weapon, pointing at the light to enact a strike, still needed her blessing to reckon. Second, the sword became sentient as she decided to create Fi, though in Shinto, swords would always have a kami within reside. Leaving instructions, she passed it on to be accompanied by her chosen one, rivaling Demise's methods to even out the odds to change the outcome. Third, for every demon lord, she decided to place more pawns on the board, assigned a select few mortals in which she had a group of sages formed. Aiding with prayers to her, they performed rituals to strengthen her might, and the servants of the goddess, various tribes hiding from plain sight, all come to serve the side of the divine light, setting all this in motion for future sight, that even without the use of the Triforce, everything will be alright. Now that she remains in a realm that exists outside of time and space, it's up to the mortals to call upon her grace. She would meddle and act accordingly to protect her cherished race, though not always making a convenient case. The acts often come after the shedding of blood, either through cleansing the world with a flood, or sending spirits down to seal demons or a tribe with the magic of Odd, in order to receive her blessings from the ground. Music practices are dedicated to her, as she will hear the sound. Tolling the bell, one of the rituals performed at the Jinja to call for the kami, is one of the ways to let the kami hear your plea. This Jinja bears a guardian deity, depicting holy robe and iconography. Stylized robe defining holy boundaries, it could trigger a prayer for a spirit unseen. What if the spirit of Hylia is the one who needs aid, as now her holy power of light had begun to fade? All the fail-saves she installed had begun breaking down. So what if the true damage is yet to be found? The shadows no longer line up as the sun's path has taken a turn for the day, and the items that are powered by her blessings are being eaten away. Calamity Ganon is cunning, though not viewed to be wise. Had secretly waged a battle out of view, in disguise. Only a part of him broke through the seal trying to regain a body to formalize, repeating the same tactic as the past seal escapes of demise. The seal never completely being broken, only a part of him slipped past the seal, actually planned up ahead of time in order for him to carry out his ordeal. Upon Hylia's mortal death, her plan had finally come to fruition, with the royal family being able to channel her power through transmission, thus inventing a loophole around the god-use prohibition, for Hylia herself to use the Triforce's permission by becoming one with the princess's mortality for recognition, while having the Triforce in acquisition, as she always had intended to commission. canon has been completely revived, the entire seal releases. Because Hylia's spirit that supported it has been broken up into many pieces. Having a fractured soul, the mastermind of this chess play, all that which channeled her powers and blessings were rid out of the way. It appears that Link will be visiting the heavily Kami's domain, with Zelda's power being mentioned to Wayne, as perhaps this was foreshadowing the premise of the new game. Make sure to leave a like and subscribe, or meet me on my Discord server to join the Cuckoo Tribe. You can support me on Ko-fi if you can spare a dime, and I hope I'll see you next time.